of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, for 40 days we have been celebrating with joyful hearts the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, his bursting from the tomb, and his defeat of the power of sin and death. He appeared to his disciples many times and told them about the kingdom of God. Today, we recall how he left this earth and returned to his Father, ascending into heaven to take his throne over all dominions and powers, trusting in his reign over all creation and submitting to his kingly yet loving rule. We will hear today the story of his parting. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Seeing we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith and make our confession to our Heavenly Father. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against thee and against our fellow men in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve thee in newness of life, to the glory of thy name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Oh,
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, Almighty God, that as we do believe thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to have ascended into the heavens, so may we also in heart and mind thither ascend, and with him continually dwell, who liveth and reigneth with thee, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when he was taken up into heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them over the course of 40 days, and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up towards heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up towards heaven? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. This is the word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you. That everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise again from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple blessing God. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
I speak in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up towards heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. There is a great sense of empowerment about this statement, the words spoken by the angels. There is a great sense of empowerment about the ascension. It implies a powerful feeling of commissioning, of being empowered. It is to be assured that you have all the tools, the skills, the ability, and the wherewithal to get on with your life. The angels are doing just that. Why are you standing staring into space? Just get on with it. You know what to do. In their words, the angels are acknowledging the accomplishment of Christ's mission on earth. Christ has shown it is possible to live a different life. Christ has shown his disciples and the world a glimpse of his kingdom, and it is now up to them, up to us, to make Christ's kingdom come here on earth. Thy kingdom come, that is our responsibility. It is we who have to make Christ's kingdom come. It is by living as Christ has commanded. It is by being empowered by the angels that we are able to enable the benefits of Christ's kingdom here in this place. We can only imagine the glory of the ascension, witnessing Christ's triumphant return to the Father, having filled humanity with the divine love and providing a glimpse of the possibility of God's kingdom on earth. God has been recognized by believers as being significantly above humanity always. And this spiritual relationship has often been expressed in special terms. Yet from our standpoint, the gap between heaven and earthly spheres may seem uncrossable. Only God's action in Christ, coming to us in the incarnation and returning to us in the ascension, bridges the gap and raises us all to the glory of heaven. In the Nicene Creed, which is proclaimed at services throughout the world every Sunday, in that creed we assert that Jesus ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. This is reflected in our reading from Luke this afternoon, and also from Luke's account of events as he wrote about them in the Acts of the Apostles. But it is not only these two accounts which we have. The theology of John, the letter to the Ephesians, to the Hebrews, the first letter of Peter, Revelation, and numerous other New Testament passages portray Jesus as having been exalted to the highest heaven. It is strange, then, that the Feast of the Ascension entered the Christian calendar formally as late as the 4th century. Though the Ascension is said to have been celebrated on the Mount of Olives from earlier times, ancient sermons, hymns, and liturgical prayers interpret the feast beautifully and poetically. Though essentially what they are saying is that the Ascension is the completion of Christ completion in Christ of the Creator, of God's original plan and purpose for humanity. That humanity is us. We are destined to ascend with Christ, passing beyond the angels, having been made after the image and likeness of God. Jesus' ascent into heaven is the precondition of Pentecost, the sending of the Holy Spirit, and so the foundation of the church. As Jesus says in our reading from St. Luke's Gospel, "And see, I am sending upon you what the Father has promised, So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. To ascend into heaven is to begin to live in the immediate presence of the Father as a full participant in the Spirit of glory, to live with God, to see him face to face. At that time, we will understand fully the true purpose of our existence here on earth, and to appreciate completely the wonder of being forever in the presence of God, be bathed in perpetual light and embraced by his love and wisdom forever. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Jesus Christ, great High Priest, living forever to intercede for us, pray for the Church, your broken body in the world. We pray for our Church and congregation of St. Bottles with Archbishopsgate, and for all churches in the diocese and throughout the world. We especially hold before you, Lord, those who are persecuted for their faith. Give them strength and help them to proclaim your word. Lord, in your mercy. Jesus Christ, King of righteousness, enthroned at the right hand of the Majesty on high, pray for the world and make it subject to your gentle rule. We hold before you, Lord, all those for whom today is a day of fear, uncertainty, the risk of mental and physical injury, and even death. We hold before you all those prevented from living the life you intend for them because of the actions of others. And we pray especially for those caught up in war and civil strife. Especially remember before you this day, Lord, the people of Ukraine and all who are caught up in the violence in that area, and all caught up in war and civil strife in any place throughout the world. Be with them, O Lord, and strengthen them. Dispel their fear and soften the hearts of those who seek to do evil to others, and strengthen the will of those who work for peace. Lord, in your mercy. Jesus Christ, Son of Man, drawing humanity into the life of God, pray for your brothers and sisters in need, distress, or sorrow. We hold before you all those who have asked for our prayers, those whom we know need our prayers, and those, O Lord, whose needs are known only unto you. Especially at this time, we pray for Mark Stein, for Tom Spencer, for Zoe Gohurici, Krina and her family, Ben Camillus, Rosemary Frischer, Katie Shannon, Kathy Lee, Flo, David Dunn, Nicola Carpenter, Mark Tilson, Maria Curtis, Barbara von Paulus, Gladys Hoskin, Tim Story, and Christopher Brown. And as we ask your blessing upon them, O Lord, we ask that you will bless also those who love and care for them at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus Christ, pioneer of our salvation, bringing us to glory through your death and resurrection, surround with your saints and angels those who have died trusting in your promises. We hold before you the recently departed John Wilson, Judy Charlton, and Henry, and all those whose anniversary falls at this time. We remember especially Frank Wheelibon, and all those whom we love and see no longer. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Heavenly Father, your Son, our Saviour, teaches us that blessed are those who mourn. Pour your comfort on all who grieve any loss this day. Especially for Sarah and her family, for the staff and colleagues at Veterans Aid, for Esther and Daphne and her family. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus Christ, Lord over all things, ascended far above the heavens and filling the universe, pray for us who receive your gifts to give us to make us work with joy in your service. Rejoicing in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Botolph, our patron, and all the saints, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Would you please stand for peace? Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. If you love me, rejoice, because I am going to the Father. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and with our spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Blessed art thou, Lord God of all creation. Through thy goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, to become for us the bread of life. Blessed art thou, Lord God of all creation. Through thy goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, to become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit,
lift up your hearts. very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, thine only Son, our Lord, because through him thou hast created all things from the beginning, and fashioned us in thine own image. Through him thou didst redeem us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born as a man, to die upon the cross, and to rise again for us. Through him thou hast made us a people for thine own possession, exalting him to thy right hand on high, and sending forth through him thy holy and life-giving Spirit. And now we give thee thanks, because after his most glorious resurrection, he appeared to his disciples, and in their sight ascended into heaven to prepare a place for us, that where he is, thither we might ascend and reign with him in glory. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and singing. Hear us, O Father, through Christ thy Son, our Lord. Through him accept our sacrifice of praise, and grant that by the power of thy Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be unto us his body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you, do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks to thee, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of his saving passion, his resurrection from the dead, and his glorious ascension into heaven. And we look for the coming of his kingdom. We pray thee to accept this, our duty and service, and grant that we may so eat and drink these holy things in the presence of thy divine majesty, that we may be filled with thy grace and heavenly blessing, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be theirs, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Celebrating his glorious ascension, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread, share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Behold the Lamb of God, that taketh away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come onto my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, our Father, who in Christ has raised up our humanity and fed us with the bread of heaven, mercifully grant that, nourished with such spiritual blessings, we may set our hearts in the heavenly places, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We give thanks, saying together, Almighty God, we thank thee for feeding us with the body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer thee our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of thy Spirit to live and work to thy praise and glory. Amen. The Lord be with you and with thy spirit. Christ, our ascended King, pour unto you the abundance of his gifts and bring you to reign with him in glory and the blessing of God Almighty. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.